Grouping your data into sections and creating totals based on those sections or all of the report data is a really useful way to show summary information. And in Access 2007, using the group, sort, and total feature has gotten much easier. Instead of using a cumbersome dialog box, you can now use this group, sort, and total pane that appears at the bottom of a report in layout view. Now you can access this pane as well as other total commands on the Report Layout Tools Formatting Contextual tab in the Grouping and Totals group. But first, let's create a new report using the Report Wizard, and then I'll show you how to use this Group, Sort, and Total pane. So I'm going to close this report because we're going to start from scratch, and then go to the Create tab in the ribbon. From here, we go to the Reports group, and then the Report Wizard command. And the first thing we need to do is pick a table or a query to base our report on. I'm going to base this report on the Customer Orders table. And I'm going to add everything except order number. So here's what we need to do. I'm going to move them all over and then just move order number back. It's a little bit quicker than having to move six over. I can move all of them over and then just move one back. Click Next. And I'm just going to go through my report wizard, but I am going to add an initial grouping level here by product name. And I can just click one time. Now, at this stage in the report wizard, you do have an option to go into your grouping options. And let's look at that now. Here it says group by product name, and I can choose to group normally or by the entire product name or by the first letter, second, third, fourth, or the first five initial levels. So these are just some additional grouping options. I'll go ahead and choose normal to match the entire thing and click OK. Let's click Next. Here we can choose a sort order. I'm going to order by customer name. And in this box, I've got some summary options. In the summary options, I can choose to add calculations to any of my fields that contain numbers. So maybe I want an average quantity, an average cost, but a total price. We'll click OK and then continue through the wizard. Choose your layout and your orientation. Choose your style. And then choose a title. I'm going to call this My Customer Orders Report. And we'll click Finish. All in all, not a bad looking report. You can see here grouped by product name. In fact, let me scroll a little bit. So here's all of my paper, sorted by customer name, and then I've got my totals down here at the bottom. So not too bad. There's about two pages in this report with grand totals at the bottom. Okay, let's look at this report now in layout view to see if we can further modify our grouping options. So I'm going to close print preview, change it from design view to layout view, because in layout view, I can get to that grouping and totals group, which I told you about in the beginning. Here, I can click the group and sort command that opens my group, sort, and total task pane at the bottom of my screen. And you can see here a group set on product name and sorted by customer name. So I can quickly and easily modify my grouping here if I want to. So let's say group on product name. Let's click that drop down arrow there. Now maybe I want to group on customer name. See that change automatically in my report. Let me switch it back to product name. You can see here's my ballpoint pens and then all the customers that have purchased ballpoint pens. But if I change that to customer name, I can now see a customer name and then all the products that that customer has purchased. Now you can see it's not sorted alphabetically, so I can change that here where it says sort by customer name. Now I'm going to choose to sort by product name. And my report changes on the fly. This is one of the terrific things about layout view is I can see my data and the layout all at once and see my changes on the fly without having to go back and forth between design view and print preview. And I'm just widening some of my fields here just a little bit. So far, not too bad. If I want to group by another level, I can add another group and group by product name. So look here, now I've grouped by customer. then by product name, which is even more detailed. Let's go into print preview so you can see how this report is really going to look when it prints. This is even better information than my additional report because it's broken stuff down to an even greater detail. And all of that again, and I'm going to close print preview, was in layout view for your report, the report layout tools formatting contextual tab, grouping and totals, and then the group and sort command. You can click group and sort, closes that pane at the bottom, click it again, opens it back up. If you'd like to remove the group on product name, you simply select it, come all the way to the right hand side, and press delete. Now if you want to reorder it, you can choose move up, move up, and now I've just adjusted it by product name and then by customer. I can move it back down. Watch as I click, my report changes on the fly. Nice and easy. Remove it all together, press the X to delete, and I continue to move back to the original layout for my report. So grouping and sorting, like I said in the beginning, much easier as long as you're using this group and sort command to open the group, sort, and total pane.